Morning, dear students. Today we are continuing the topic Guna Vijnaniyam. Already we have discussed among the 41 gunas, Pancha Arthas and Vimshati gunas or Gurvadi gunas already. So today we are continuing with the Buddhi Prayatnyanta guna or Atma guna, Adhyatma guna. So this Buddhi Prayatnyanta guna or Atma guna, Adhyatma guna, they are actually six in number. Buddhi, Sukham, Dukkham, Iccha, Dvesha, Prayatna. So these six four, Buddhi, Prayatnanda Guna or Atma Guna or Adhyatma Guna. Then we have to discuss one by one. First of all, Buddhi. Buddhi is having the synonyms Buddhi, Vanisha, Dishana, Dhi, Prajna, Medha, etc. What Tarkasangaranara says about Buddhi? Sarva Vivahara Hetu. Guna, Buddhi, Jnanam, Sadvividha, Smridhi, Anibhavaha, Chapiti. Sarva Vyavahara Hetu. For Buddhi is that which is responsible for all sorts of Vyavahara, that is physical, mental and verbal actions. Kaika, Manasika and Vajika Karma. It is that Jnana, knowledge. It is of two types, Smriti and Anibhavaha. What is meant by Smriti? Samskara Matra Janya Jnanam, Smritihi. Samskara means which arises from the previous impressions or the impressions which are already there, existing. Seeing a route, you are going to a destination. First of all, it is a totally strange path or a new location. So then you will be using the help of map. Once you came through that route and you reached your destination, or you are having the repeated journeys, you will get the route very clear. It is impress. That impression is there already in your mind. That is called as smriti. Tad bhinnam jnanam anubhava. Other than smriti, the direct experience is anubhava. So, for the purpose of knowledge, gathering knowledge, every person will be having the anubhava first, direct experience. Later, it becomes smriti or the memory. So, this anubhava, again you can divide into two, that is yadhartha, ayadhartha, Chaiti, sa dvividha, yadhartha, ayadhartha, chaiti. So, jnana, knowledge attained through samskara is smriti. Smriti is of two types, bhavita smriti and abhavita smriti. Knowledge attained during sleep or dreams is bhavita smriti. Knowledge attained during jagrata avastha is abhavita smriti. Then, we were discussing about anubhava. Jnana, knowledge or jnana attained through direct experience is anubhava. Anubhava is of two types, that is yadhartha anubhava and ayadhartha anubhava. So what is yadhartha anubhava? Real knowledge. Tadvadi tatprakaraka anubhavaha yadhartha sa eva prama ityuchyate yatharachate itam rachata vidijnanam. That is tatprasangrahakara definition of yadhartha anubhava. Tadvadi tatprakaraka anubhavaha. In an object you are getting the same knowledge, real knowledge. For example, seeing a mobile phone, you are getting the knowledge that this is the mobile phone, this is not the TV remote. That is the yathartha anubhava. That is also called as prama. For example, here Tarkasangrahara says, yatha rajate itam rajatam idi jnanam. Seeing the rajata, that is silver, one can understand it as rajata. He is not understanding it as platinum. He is not understanding it as gold. That is yathartha anubhava. Then, what is meant by, before going to ayathartha anubhava, we have to see the subdivisions of yathartha anubhava. It is of four types. Yathartha anubhavaha chaturvidha pratyaksha anumiti upamiti shabda bhedat tat karanam api chaturvidham pratyaksha anumana upamana shabda bhedat. So yathartha anubhava four types. The knowledge thus attained is also four in number. It becomes clear by seeing this tabular column. In this tabular column, the first column says the means or methods. Then in the second column says about the knowledge attained. So this pratyaksha anumiti upamiti shabda, and you are getting the knowledge respectively pratyaksha anumana upamana shabda. Then what is meant by ayathartha anubhava? That is unreal knowledge. Tat abhavavati tat prakaraka anubhavaha ayathartha sa eva aprama ityuchyate yatha shukto idam rajatam idi jnanam. Wrong understanding of something is ayathartha anubhava. It is also called as aprama. For example, understanding shukti, that is pearl, as silver, that is the ayathartha anubhava. Ayathartha anubhava is of three types, samshaya, vibhireya and tarka. What is meant by samshaya? Ekaspin dharmani viruddha jnana dharma vaishishtya avadahi jnanam samshaya yathastanurva purishova iti. You can think about Sarparijavibhranti, which we had already discussed. Seeing the rope, someone is doubting it as sarp. That is Sarparijavibhranti. Similarly, Egasmin Dharmani Virudha Nana Dharma Vaishishtavagahi Gnana. Different confusing knowledge raised on a single thing, that is samshaya. For example, if a person is walking during the night and there is a source of light is very minimal, at that time, seeing the pillar, he is having the doubt whether it is really a pillar or whether it is a man standing there. That is the example given. And again, vibhraya means mithyajnana, the exactly opposite or the wrong knowledge you are getting. Yatha chupto idam rajatam idijnana. Vibhraya is mithyajnana, which is an illusion, we can see. Understanding shukti as rajata, that is a vibhraya. Then comes the tarka. Tarka means what? Vyapya aropena vyapaka aropaha tarkaha yatha yadavanyihi nasyat arhidumaha api nasyat iti. Tarka is vyapya aropa by vyapaka aropa. Tarka Sankaragara says. What is meant by vyapya? It is something which is less extensive or that which may present in the less area, less pervaded substance. Vyapaka is something which is wide extensive. Consider dhuma and vanyi. Vanyi is fire, a source of fire. It may be present in the kitchen, but the dhuma, smoke, is wide extensive. So, tarka is a statement, in case the statement quoting absence of smoke using the absence of fire. Such marking develops tarka. Next one is sukha. Tarka Sangraha says, sarvesham anukoola vedaniyam sukha. So, vedana usually we interpret it as something which is discomfort or pain. So, here for better understanding, vedana can be interpreted as experience. So, whenever the pain the experience becomes supportive or wholesome or which is conducive, we can call it as sukha. Sarvesham anukoola vedaniyam sukha. And again, acharya denotes sukha satyakam arogya. So here he denotes sukha as arogya. Then sukha can be divided into three, that is ahika sukha, surga sukha, and moksha sukha. Dukha means upakhada lakshanam dukha, that is prashastapada bhushya's definition. That which produces upakha or pida or discomfort is called as dukha. Pratikula vedana. In sukha it was anukula, that which was supportive. Here pratikula means the experience is not supportive, it is not conducive, that is called as dukkha. And again we have to highlight the charaka statement, that is vikaro dukkha mevacha, vikaro vyadhi, that is dukkha according to Ajari Charaka. Dukkha is of two types, that is aihika dukkha and amushmita dukkha. Then comes icha. Icha kama. Icha is kama, desire. Swartham parartham va aprapta prarthana icha. That is what Prashastapada Bhashya says. Desire for something which cannot be obtained for oneself or someone. That is called as icha. That is what the interesting thing about the desires. Desires we cannot fulfill. If we are fulfilling one desire, another one will rise. And again the types of icha. First one is kama, that is the sexual desire. Abhilash, that is desire for food and drinks. Rag, it is a constant attachment for something. Sankalpa, desire for something in the future. Karana, desire to eradicate someone else's pain. Vairag, that is one's own desire to give up sensory objects or momentary pleasures because of its ill effects. These momentary pleasures, whatever may be, they cannot satisfy a person. From that, the person develops aversion towards that. That is called as vairag. Then upatha. Upatha means the desire to betray or cheat someone. Then bhava is the hidden desire. Then comes the dvesha, krodho desha, Tarka Sangraha says. According to Tarka Sangraha, krodha, we can interpret it as anger or anguish. Dukkha anujanma dvesha. So dvesha is manifested along with dukkha, we can say. This dvesha is the sibling of the dukkha. Usually with dukkha, the person will be getting, whenever he is in dukkha. So first of all, he will be sad, and afterwards, he will develop the anger or anguish or a sort of frustration towards the cause or positive factor of the dukkha. So, that is called as dvesha. Then, types of dvesha are krodha, droga, manyu, akshama, amarsha. Then comes the prayat, sixth one, and last one among the this buddhi prayatna adhukuna. Kritihi prayatna. Prayatna is the kriti, which can be interpreted as effort. It is almost an action. So it is of its synonyms are samrambha and utsara. So for doing any sort of activities, we need to take some effort. That is called as prayatna. Prayatna is of two types: jivana purvaka prayatna and icha dvesha purvaka prayatna. So jivana purvaka prayatna is responsible for functions of prana, apana, etc. during sleep, and active coordination of indriya during conscious stage. You know, even if we are sleeping, our inner mechanism inside our body, it will be functioning. So that is called as that effort that by the various systems together, which is called as jivana purvaka prayatna. Whereas Ichha Dvesha Purvaka Prayatna is that which is responsible for our physical activities based on our Ichha and Dvesha. We are deciding that we will go there or we will have this because we will be having that desire, Ichha. So we are going to fulfill. So Dvesha means we don't want to meet that person. We don't want to go that particular place because we are having anger or we are not feeling any sort of affinity towards that place. So we are doing our good effort to avoid that situation. That is, these are the examples we can give for Ichha, Dvesha, Purvaka Prayatna. So we have so far discussed about Pancha Arthas, Gurvadi Gunas 20 in number, and 6 Adhyatma Gunas. So 5 plus 20, 25 plus 6, 31, and remaining 10 in number among 41. Remaining 10 are Paradi Guna, Paradi Samanya Guna. Charaka says, Paraparatve Yuktischa, Sankhya Samyoga Evacha, Vibhagascha Pudhaktamcha, Parimana Madhavicha, Samskaro Abhyasa Ittede Guna Prokta Paradeha. So, Paratva, Aparatva Yukti, Sankhya Samyoga Vibhaga, Pudhaktva, Parimana, Samskara and Abhyasa Paradeha. So, these guna are significant for successful conduct of chikitsa. Paratva, Aparatva. First of all, we had to discuss Paratva and Aparatva are superiority and inferiority respectively in the context of Desha, Kala, Vaya, Mana, Paka, Veda, Desa, etc. So these two have to be discussed together. So, but for examples, we can say Desha related with respect to Desha. So for a swastha, healthy individual, Jangala Desha is considered as Param and Anupa Desha is upper. Means Jangala Desha is considered as healthy, or that's right, that's superior, it is Param. And Anupa Desha is upper. And considering the Kala, for a swastha, Visarga Kala is the Dakshinayana Kala. Visarga Kala is Param and Adana Kala is Uttarayana Kala is upper. Again, with respect to age, in health point of view, Yavana is Param and Bali and Vardhakya are upper. We all know that during the time of yavana, a person will be more healthy, and especially during the childhood and again the old age, the people are having more health issues. Then comes related with the mana, means pramana or measurements of body parts. And individuals with proper sharira pramana is para, and one without proper sharira pramana is upper. In our classics, descriptions are there for conveying this thing. This much angular, our body or the parts of regions, etc. The measurements. So if the measurements are accordingly, then it is para. And if proper measurements are not there, then that is upper. Then paka or vipaka. So for vartha shamana, madhura vipaka is para and kata vipaka is upper. Means madhura vipaka obviously alleviate vata dosha and kata vipaka is increase. Then with respect to virya, we can say for vata dosha. Sorry, Vata and Kapashamana, Ushna Virya is para and Shita Virya is upper, because by the Shita Virya, the Vata Kapavritti takes place. And with respect to Rasa, we can say for Sharira portion, Madhura Rasa is para, means it is considered as best, and Kashaya Rasa is upper, means Kashaya Rasa does not having the effect of Sharira portion. Then we have to see the divisions of Paratva and Aparatva. Both Paratva and Aparatva can be divided into two, that is Dikkrita and Kalakrita. So here one with respect to Dik and another with respect to Kala. So in relation with Desha, the person who is from a distant place, we will be having Dikkrita Paratva, and person who is living nearer will be having Dikkrita Aparatva. So suppose the two persons are there, or suppose two persons in family, one person is in very far from the native, another is in the native. So the person who is far away, he is getting the Dikkrita Paratva, and another, those who are inside in his home, considering that land, he is having Dikkrita Aparatva. Then Kalakrita, in relation with Kala, that is the time, Jeshta, elder child will be having Kalakrita Paratva, because he is the elder one, and Kanishta, the younger child will be having Kalakrita Aparatva. Among Paradiguna, next is Yukti. Yuktischa Yojana Yadu Yujjati Acharya Charaka 6. Yukti is Yojana, which means to connect or unite. Ajay Chakravani clarifies, Yukti in Chikitsa point of view, that it is the prescription of suitable medicines to a patient. So there is a logical application of our prescription of the medicine. According to this condition, this medicine will be nice, or this vihara will be nice. That is called as Yukti in Chakravani point of view. Then comes Sankhya. Sankhya Sya Ganitam. Ganitam means what is arithmetics or mathematics. Ganitam Ganana Vyavahara Hetu Ega Dvi Trayati Sankhya. That is Yogi Dhrinathasan comments on this topic. Sankhya is the property which is responsible for counting like 1, 2, 3, etc. These are also very much important. Egatvati Vyavahara Hetu Sankhya Sa Navatrevi Vrtihi Egaadi Parartha Paryanta Egatam Dividam Nityam Anityam Cha Iti Nityagadam Nityam Anityagadam Anityam Dittvadigam to Sarvatra Anityameva. That is Tarka Sangrahara's explanation. So Sankhya is responsible for usages like Egatam, oneness, etc. Example, this is one. These are two. For example, doshas are three in number, maybe three doshas. Such number. Sankhya resides in all nine dravyas. Sankhya ranges from Eka, that is one, to Paratha. Paratha is an infinite number. Millions, 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 we can say. That is Paratha. Ekat, that is oneness, is of two types. It is Nitya and Anitya. Ekatva present in Nitya Dravya or Nitya. Ekatva which are present in Anitya Dravya or Anitya. Dittva, Trittva, Trittva, etc. Always Anitya. Then, some practical applications. So, this number, in our different contexts, we are coming across. Like, maximum number of bus 3 that can be administered on the same day is 3. Here the number is relevant. Ajari clearly says, there exists, we don't need to apply more than 3 vasti because he is telling that 3 doshas are there. Similarly, karma vasti, kara vasti, and yoga vasti are vasti schedules based on number. In karma vasti, you know, that is a 30 day schedule. In kara vasti, 15 days, and again yoga vasti, 8 days. Then, types of diseases are calculated using number. For example, 18 types of kushta, 20 types of prameha. Again, in classics, we can see that description of Ashtamahagata, 8 major diseases. Then in Aushadha Yoga, the number of parts of individual dravya is important. We will say this dravya has to take one part, another dravya should be two parts, or the taila or any other kalka should be of three parts, such description. There also this number is having much importance. Then comes the next one among the paradiguna is Samyoga. Samyukta Vyavahara Hetuhu Samyoga. Samyoga. Punaha, dayoho bahunam va dravyanam sabhadi bhava. So guna which is responsible for union of two or more substance, that is called as samyoga. So types of samyoga here, twofold division is there, karmaja samyoga and samyogaja samyoga, that is the twofold division. For example, hasta pustaka samyoga, whenever you are taking a book in your with your hand, so the contact established between your hand and a book by the action initiated by the hand, that is karmaja samyoga. Then comes samyogaja samyoga, that is sharira pustaka samyoga. First you established contact between your hand and a book, and afterwards the same book got contact with your body as well, that is samyogaja samyoga. Then threefold division according to Vaisheshika Darshana, that is anyatara karmaja samyoga, ubhaya karmaja samyoga, samyogaja samyoga. So first of all, Anyatara Karmaja Samyoga, the contact established between a tree and a bird is example for Anyatara Karmaja Samyoga. Here, Samyoga has taken place due to the bird's action, because a tree cannot go towards the bird. A bird can come, it may be flying and landing upon a tree. Then, what is Upaya Karmaja Samyoga? Here, the both objects which are making this Samyoga are having the active participation. For example, the contact established between two fighting goats, that is Ubhaya Karmaja Samyoga. Whenever they are fighting each other, they are established a Samyoga between these two goats, that is the action of both goats. Then Samyoga is Samyoga, as I already mentioned, that is the Sharira Pustaka Samyoga, the contact established between a book and the body by the contact established between the book and hand is example for Samyoga Samyoga. Then comes the Vibhaga. Vibhaga is just opposite that of Samyoga. Its divisions are also exactly opposite. Guna which is responsible for separation or division or fragmentation, we can call it as Vibhaga. Samyoga Nashago Guno Vibhaga Sarvadrevyavritti, guna which destroys samyoga, is vibhaga. Types of vibhaga, same that of samyoga, karmaja vibhaga. For example, hasta pustaka vibhaga. Conduct withdraw between hand and a book by action initiated by the hand. Then samyogaja vibhaga is charira pustaka vibhaga. Contact loss between a book and body by the contact withdraw between the book and hand. Then threefold division also same. Anyatara karmaja vibhaga, ubhaya karmaja vibhaga and samyogaja vibhaga. So the contact withdraw between a tree and a bird is called as anyatara karmaja vibhaga. Here vibhaga has taken place due to the bird's action, because the tree cannot move from a certain limb. The initiation has to be done by the bird itself. That's why it is anyatara karmaja vibhaga. Then ubhaya karmaja vibhaga, when the two persons withdraw their hands after a shake hand. Here that is the active participation. For the suppression, there is the active participation by the two individuals. That's why it is called as ubhaya karmaja vibhaga. Then samyogaja vibhaga is same, that is sharira pustaka vibhaga. The contact that lost between a book and the body by the contact withdrew between book and hand. That is example for samyogaja vibhaga. Then comes the pruthakta. Pruthaktam syat asamyogo vailakshnyam anekata. Guna which is responsible for differentiation of substances. By that we are distinguishing the objects among the oil or the oil substances. We are differentiating krita, this is taila, this is vasa. That is prudhak vyavahara asadharana karanam prudhakta. Prudhakta is asadharana karanam. For usages like this is different from another. Prudhakta is guna which make one dravya different from another. That is distinguishing or giving the distinct tag. Then comes the parimanam. Parimanam punaha manam. Mana vyavahara asadharana karanam parinamam tat chaturvidam anu dirgam mahat khrusvamcha. Parimana is mana, that is measurement. It is of four types, that is anu, dirga, mahat and khrusva. Amarakosha. Mana is of three types, that is yautava, dhruvaya and payamana. Yautava or pautava mana is measurement of weight or mass, like we are using expressing in kilogram, grams, etc. So dhruvaya mana is measurement of volume. Usually we for the liquid substances, we are using this one with units like liter, milliliter, etc. Payamana is measurement of length, which we express as for the length like centimeter, meter, etc. Then broader classification of mana relevant in Ayurveda, that is tula mana, measurement of weight or mass, that is relevant by measuring ingredients of a formulation. You know, without measuring, we cannot prepare any formulation. So we are making each parts and the substance ingredients we will weigh, that is by the tulaman. Then anguliman, measurement using finger, relevant where it is relevant by preparing various yantras or shastras. For example, dhuma yantra, this much angula in length, which is advised. Again vasti yantra is vasti yantra also, it is mentioned vasti yantra, it is having this much length. Acharya specifies. Then measurements of different body parts, we are using anguliman in marma vibhaga, or in the marma we are telling this part the length of this particular marma or the length, etc. We are expressing. Then prastamana is the measurement of volume. Quantity of mala will be measured after vaman and viraj, that is mentioned. For then only we are determining the samyak shuddhi based on the quantity, whether it is the shuddhi is moderate, whether it is good quality or whether it is inferior. That is for that also this prastamana we can mention, we can use. Then quantity of various components of sharira, that is, for example shukra, ojasartha, etc. based on volume. Then it is important while preparing different formulations also. We are measuring and adding, not weighing, we are measuring. In some cases, in weighing the solid substances, we are weighing, where tulamana is important. But whenever you are adding liquid substances, here the prastamana is having, or for the volume we are using. Then comes the samskar, second last one, samskaraha. Karanam matam, samskaro hi gunandaradhane muchade, karanam punaha, swabhavigana, dravyana, api samskara. So, samskar is the property by which a dravya undergoes modification of its qualities. Types of samskara, samskaraha travita, vego, bhavanaha, sthidistavagascha. These are the divisions. What is meant by vega? Vega is guna of prithvi, aptejo, vayu, which is among the panchamahabhutas, prithvi, aptejo, vayu, and manas. It is responsible for action. Then bhavana, it is vishesha guna of atma alone. It is born out of anubhava and is hetu for smriti. I already discussed, first of all experience occurs and after that it leads to smriti. Then sthitisthapaka means samskara, which is responsible for bringing something to original state from altered state. For example, elasticity or an elastic substance or rubber band, you know. If you are pulling it, then it elongates, then it will come to the normal state. That is tejasthavaka samskara, which is responsible for bringing something to original state from the altered state. Then the last one is among the paradigana, that is abhyasa. Bhavabhyasanam abhyasaha shilanyam sadatakriya. Repeated use of any bhavapadarthas like dravya, guna and karma is abhyasa. Shilanya and sadatakriya, synonyms of abhyasa. With this, we are finishing the guna vijnaniyam topics, and I always redirect my dear students, there is no shortcut to success other than hard work. So please continue working hard. Thank you.